All right, you bought 35 acres. The first thing you want to do is put a food plot in, but we're here to tell you that's not the first step in making this a destination hunting property.
It seems like the most common step. I bought a farm.
Every time.
I found the open areas. I'm gonna put in food plots and it's gonna be jam up. It's gonna be awesome.
Well, especially on small properties. Everyone has that vision of hunting over the food plots, killing the deer, you know, it's just what we're almost ingrained to think about. But specifically on a small property, it is critical that you are holding deer on that acreage instead of expecting or having to rely on those deer being on neighboring properties and you just attracting them over.
Yeah.
If you hold them, you're way more in control. And so for the first step, if the cover is poor on a property, which a lot of properties, there's not great cover.
That's right.
You've got to create it. And so that's what we're staying in today is a bedding area that has been created first and foremost before food plots were even planted on this property.
Bedding, creating secure bedding should be the foundation of successful layouts of a farm. And especially the smaller acres, smaller parcels.
Right.
So if you've got 35 acres, 20 acres, even 50 acres, you should be working on defining the bedding, putting the deer on you during daylight when they're bedded down, and then build off of that. You can have a very successful food plot that is the best thing on the market in the middle of a Walmart parking lot, but it doesn't mean that deer are coming to it.
Especially during daylight hours, right? I mean, you can have you have the best looking food plot out there and put $300 an acre to that food plot, but still only be experiencing nighttime activity or nocturnal buck movement. And that's frustrating to hunt. You want that experience of seeing deer on you during daylight. But the best way to do that is to cut down the distance that they have to travel to a high value resource. There's a place for food plots, but it's really not the priority. Owning the deer during daylight, making sure they're on you, giving them that security aspect is super important. Like, you know, we hear about food, cover, and water being, you know, the three main things we need. Well, we need cover and security too to make them come to the food during daylight hours. But if that's not the situation, even if you don't plant a food plot, this property could still be very successful by having the cover.
That's
even
right.
If you don't ever plant a food plot.
For sure.
The foundation is making sure that this cover type is available and that you are doing your part to make it the foundation of a property. That's what it's built around.
Yeah.
Create
so
this first.
If you have a smaller parcel and you're trying to make it better, the first move you should make is trying to create it to where deer are bedding on that piece.
Yep.
And if you create it to where, and it may be multiple areas within your parcel that they can bed in. And everything after that, you can make the mock scrapes or the food plots or the water holes to attract them by, but you need them to be bedding on you. So at least you know you have that going in your advantage versus the neighbors.
Absolutely.
And truth be told, for many people across the country, it's not going to be that hard to create better bedding on your place than your neighbors.
Absolutely. It's cheap. It's easy. This was created in like 6 days.
I don't know if it's that easy in comparison to driving a tractor and planting a food plot. But it's relatively easy to create great, great bedding with a chainsaw.
This was done one man, 6-7 tanks of fuel, an acre and a half in size.
And that was you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it may only take half the time for other guys.
Yeah, right. But it's feasible to create good quality cover in a short amount of time frame.
Yeah.
And that be the basis that everything else is built around. So we have to consider access. Access can be limited on small properties. So once you know where you can and can't get to on a property, if you're coming in from the north or you have to come in from the south or the east, build that foundation of cover off of your access, then we can start talking about adding the other features, food plots, and really steering deer with other habitat techniques. But number one, this right here has got to be the priority.
If you want
daylight activity, which we all do, and if you want consistency over year after year after year, because we've seen where food plots have failed, you don't get rain, seeds bat, you know, all
army
these
worms.
Different army worms. Yeah. All these different scenarios can be thrown out there, but guess what? This doesn't stop.
No.
This keeps coming year after year and you can maintain it for, you know, 5-10 years very easily with prescribed fire. So this is the foundation. Hopefully that helps you guys get more daylight experience on hunting mature whitetails on small parcels.